Integrating pimp with standard adapters can make it easy to connect pimp, but it can also limit the pimp data model. The Inriver Integration Framework focuses on this issue of modeling and decouples the adapter implementations to focus on the target system. The framework is explained in detail on the community side and is summarized in this diagram, so let's go ahead and take a look. Here we have data flowing through pimp from left to right. Data flows from source systems into Inriver, through the integration framework, through the specific adapter, and finally the data arrives at the target system. The target system could be Salesforce Commerce or Adobe Magento Commerce. In Inriver, we have the pimp model with all of the different entity types and relations. The pimp model is typically specific to the products of the company using the pimp, and this data model varies a lot, but it could be sourced in the following way. From ERP, we have the SKU. From PLM, we have the products. And from the product configurator, we have the assortments. And from dump, we have the resources. To specify how channels are exported, the framework also sets up the entity type target exporter. This entity contains information specific to the channel being exported by the framework. The pimp model is mapped into the framework using the integration model. The integration model is a JSON document that maps pimp to the outbound model. This outbound model is generic and defined by the integration framework. And keeping this model generic makes sense as it enables higher quality standard adapters, but it does not fit with every pimp model out there. Also, as the integration framework runs as extensions in Inriver, it has limitations in memory and relies on the channel structure being in sync. The model is set up in the control center, and here I have a basic example using the Inriver demo model. This model has been extended with unique IDs on channels and channel nodes for the framework to function. Here you specify the entity type to map from, and in the case of variations, you can specify a list of entity types. Now that I have set up the integration model, I can begin to run the adapters of the framework. Here I'm running the custom code example from the community page, and the integration model is available for inspection. Testing the integration model in this way is useful, as debugging is not possible for the Salesforce B2B adapter or the Adobe Magento adapter. Both standard adapters has a test mode, but relies on the integration framework being configured correctly with an integration model. Visit InriverCommunity.com to learn more about Inriver and the Inriver Integration Framework.